Adams. He is a friend of the show. He's a closer friend of James Jones, receiver, formerly of the Packers, currently of the Raiders, but not for long. He took to social media, the Raiders took to real life to say, we will trade Davante Adams, but we want a second round pick for him. Davante Adams, likely a future Hall of Famer, 95 touchdowns already in his career,
beast,
into the season, an absolute beast. Quite literally, you will hear a lot of dialogue about Davante Adams today. There is no better show to hear the Davante Adams discussion than this show. Not saying this pridefully, but because of that man on the far end.
Say it with
James
your chest.
Jones, I believe maybe teammate. Yep. Of Davante Adams with the Green Bay Packers. Obviously, James Jones currently covers the Raiders, formerly played for the Raiders. Davante Adams currently played for the Raiders, exists in a group chat with Davante Adams. Of all the people that will talk about Davante Adams today, just know this show will give you the inside scoop. Glad you're here. Turn your volumes up. James Jones, if there is one team, one team that Davante Adams should want to join, just one, what team is it?
Well, since you intro me like that, let me just tell you where you're going since the conversations I had. No, it's the Saints. It's the Saints for me. Get back with your brother, Derek Carr, who you had an all-pro season with, right? The dude that raised you, a lot of people don't know, Keith Williams, is the receiver coach at New Orleans.
What do you mean raised you?
Elaborate. Raised him. Coached him at Fresno State, was a father figure to him at Palo Alto High School in the Bay Area. Boom, boom, boom.
James, man.
Dr. Ives crossed.
He's
a receiver coach at New Orleans. So if there's anybody that wants Davante over there, I'm sure he would want Davante over there as well. Then you have Derek Carr, right? Okay, Saints may not have enough money to bring Davante Adams over there right now. Hey, my brother. Hey, foe. You making a lot of money, man. 100 M's last time I checked, something like that. Hey, take a little bit off the back end.
Restructure.
Bring me in here. Another thing, you out the cold. You in the dome, you know what I'm saying? You ain't got to worry about none of the elements, you know what I'm saying? You play Carolina, you play in another dome in Atlanta. Hey, man, listen, I think the Saints would make a lot of sense for Davante Adams. You're going to walk in there with a dude you already played with, you have chemistry with, you won an all-pro with. I think the Saints would make a lot of sense right now. And I don't think the Saints are far off. I think the Saints could compete, especially in this division, and get to the playoffs.
Hey, he played for that head coach, too, right?
Dennis Allen.
No, Dennis Allen. He missed Dennis Allen.
I need you to do something for me, James, because nobody else is going to say what you are about to say, and this matters. You mentioned Keith Williams. I'm looking at Keith Williams. I've never heard his name a day before in my life.
That's crazy.
Fresno State wide receiver coach from 2009 to 2011. I believe Davante Adams probably would have been at Fresno somewhere along those lines.
Yeah.
So it's safe to say Keith Williams recruited him back when Davante may have been 16 to 17.
Yeah. Mm. So when I was training, Davante Adams was still in high school before Fresno State. He used to come out there and train with myself and Coach Dub.
You that old?
Huh?
You that old?
I'm not old, I'm young. he used to come out there and train with myself and Keith Williams. Keith Williams recruited him to Fresno State, coached him at Fresno State. He still, every single offseason, wherever Keith Williams was, when he wasn't in the National Football League, he would go and train with Keith Williams. Now Keith Williams is at the Saints. His old quarterback from Fresno State from the Raiders is at the Saints. Really good chemistry. I think the Saints would be a perfect fit, and I, like I said before, I do not think the Saints are far off. Really good defense. You get another playmaker in there to go with Shaheed and Chris Olave, we got action.
Really good. That's really good.
Wow. That was really good, James. That's a lot of good insight, right? The James sources.
Yeah, that's the same.
We got
that's
action.
Good.
Boy, you like James Bond. You know everything. Anyway. I'm going to go with the Bills.
Ooh, I like that, too.
Now, this is what I'm going to say, though. Now, it's one thing to play with your teammate at quarterback, but it's another thing to play with a superstar like I'm a superstar. Mm. You put two superstars together, you see what Stephon Diggs and Josh Allen did together. Listen, come to the Bills. I'm just like visualizing how it will look. Right? You got a good coach, right? You got a good team. They're used to winning. We in the playoffs every year.
Yeah.
Good team or bad team, no matter what it is, we're going to be in the playoffs. And then you playing with the best player in football right now today in Josh Allen. I was thinking about it. When I watched the game against the Ravens, against the Bills, it was obvious. It was evident that they don't have no superstar wide receiver. They do all these different, like, motions and trying to, you know.
Trying to
hide this receiver, that receiver. No. With Davante Adams, you have to do that.
Nope.
Yo, line him up. You put your best on my best, and he's going to win. And I think it's finally a time where he's tired of playing with quarterbacks that's just mediocre, right? And I'm going to be honest. Derek Carr, I like Derek Carr. He has some really, really high moments in his career. He has some really low moments in his career.
Yeah.
he ain't never seen a dude like Josh Allen. Right now, right now,
yeah, I get it. Yeah, no,
Aaron Rodgers is nice.
I understand what you're saying,
yo,
sir.
It's 3rd and 8, yo. Yeah. I'm not open. I'm gonna run and get this first down. So I just love to see the Buffalo Bills and Josh Allen and Devontae Adams. Oh my God, that's box like office, that. Watch out.
Well, I think what you were saying bad. Is super evident on the film with the Ravens is the Ravens came out and they had not played man all year long. They said, hey, go beat us for the Shakir. Go beat us, tight end. Keon Coleman, go beat us. They didn't have a receiver to separate Devontae Adams as that. I got to go with the Washington Commanders as a team I like.
Okay.
Couple reasons. Commanders have this unique and sudden window right now with Jaden Daniels on a rookie quarterback deal. The Eagles issues, the Dallas Cowboys issues. There's a chance they get this Devontae Adams trade done. I don't know if they're willing to do it, but you pair him with Scary Terry. Tell me a better duo in the league than Scary Terry and Devontae Adams.
Chris like, Olave.
No, come on. No, I would still take it. But I think that, you know, Devontae in the draft was really effusive in his praise toward Jaden Daniels. And Jaden has shown that he can be a stud in this league. Now, it's early. But really, you look at a quarterback that is on the rise. For me, it's him. I think, you know, Devontae can play 2 to 3 years. Another thing that's not being looked at a lot, I think that the Saints offensive line is good. I think the Bills offensive line is good. I think the Washington Commanders offensive line is excellent. Why do I say that? They've only allowed the 5th least pressures in the league. That gives Jaden Daniels more time for these deeper developing routes that Devontae Adams can run. He's not just this underneath slant route defender. He's not just running a hitch. You give this quarterback time in the thought process to get these routes open down the field.
I want to ask you a quick question. I'm the agent, and yes, you're the Washington Commanders front office. And I would say, first of all, he is a rookie. That matters. I want you to answer that question. My older superstar wide receiver with a rookie. And then second of all, is even though they're 3-1 right now, is that right? 3-1?
They're 3-1.
Oh. Yeah, they're 3-1.
Like they're not good. They punted four times in 4 games.
Right, but I would ask you this. Like, my guy wants to be in the playoffs. He wants to play in an NFC Championship game. He wants to play in a Super Bowl.
Yeah.
You think that in the first next 2 years he can do that? With
I think
team?
The Commanders are a team that's on the rise. I don't know if they're getting the playoffs this year. He wants to be with a quarterback, and he wants to be in a franchise that is on the up and coming. I think Dan Quinn has done a really good job right now with Washington. And like I alluded to, it's the Eagles and the Cowboys. All of a sudden, they're facing some external issues. Like, man, are we good enough? Like, I could sit here today, and I will sit here today, say the Commanders are the best team in the NFC East.
If it's one team, Devontae should want to go to. Huh? One team. Please. One team.
Say someone crazy.
It's got to be the Chiefs. Mm. If there's one team Devontae should want to go to, it's got to be the Chiefs. Money can buy a lot of things. Shady McCoy, you know this better than anybody at the desk. Money cannot buy a Hall of Fame jacket. Yeah. It can't do it. It can buy a gold jacket. It can't buy a Hall of Fame jacket. Yeah. Money can't buy Super Bowl confetti falling on you as you're on the field. It can't buy that. Mm-mm. If it can buy one thing, money can't buy those things. And if Devontae Adams has acquired a lot of money, he went to Vegas in large part for Derek Carr, but he also went no state taxes, and he went for $120 million. You've got your bread at this point in time. Devontae, go to the Chiefs. Mm. Win a ring. Us all at this desk would take the Chiefs over the field. If you want the ring, you go to the Chiefs. You go there for 1 year. You see how it shakes out. You're not going to get no new money this year. At the end of the year, you got no more guaranteed money left. You figure out your move after that. But also, you've already made $120 million in your last deal, not counting your first deal. So you got $120 mil. Now go get a Super Bowl ring. Now go solidify your All-Pro status. Now go solidify your name etched in the history of the National Football League for years, years, decades, and centuries to come. If Devontae should want to go somewhere, it has got to be the Chiefs. That secures the Super Bowl ring, which is the one thing he hasn't been able to catch. He caught a lot of things. He ain't caught the ring just yet.
Could you imagine if the Raiders traded in division to the Chiefs, who everyone hates and everyone's trying to be, what the AFC GMs and head coaches would think about the Raiders?
Remember this.
That?
Here's the thing.
They're making the best team better.
But remember, we saw this before. Shady, I think you know because you either played with this person or at least know of this person. Remember Orlando Brown, I believe, left tackle. Yeah. Zeus. Orlando Brown Jr., if I'm not mistaken. He played for the Ravens.
Yeah.
Played for the Ravens. The Ravens and the Chiefs' arch nemesis in the 2019-2020 era. The Ravens traded Orlando Brown to the Chiefs. So the question was, why in the world did they do that? Andy, help me if I'm wrong with any of my statistics doing it off the top of my head. Why did they do that? Because they realized at the end of this year, we can't pay Orlando Brown.
Yeah.
So either Orlando Brown is going to walk for nothing, or at least we're going to give something for him. So with that being said, the Raiders ain't competing with the Chiefs. Let's be honest. The Raiders are competing with themselves at this point in time. The Raiders aren't like, oh, we're going to beat the Chiefs to the Super Bowl. No. If you can get the most from the Chiefs, get what you can from the Chiefs. But for me, James, Devontae should exclusively want to go to the team that can win him a Super Bowl.
Yeah, and that's cheating, man. I'm just telling you now.
Why do you say that, man?
If that happens, man, I ain't coming to work no more. It shouldn't really be people.
I'm going to come to work.
AFC it shouldn't really be people breaking down film and all that because we know who's going. Come on, man. Devontae Adams to the Kansas City Chiefs would be crazy. But, yeah, who wouldn't want to go with Patrick Mahomes? Because you're right. Devontae Adams is chasing a Super Bowl, and Devontae Adams is chasing Hall of Fame. And to get with the best player in football over the last, how long, Patty, been in?
Nine years.
So let's say eight then.
Eight, you know
what I'm saying? Because his first year he didn't play. So over that span in Patty's time, he's been the best player in the National Football League, and you put one of the best receivers with him and with Andy Reid. Problem.
I got a question for you, 2-5, because you, more than anybody at this desk, have been in this position. Again, in this show, you got 39 years of NFL experience. So quite literally, most anybody should have experienced something at this desk, whether it's making millions, whether it's getting cut, whether it's throwing touchdowns, whether it's catching touchdowns. We've experienced it all. Shady, you've been in a similar position, not in an identical position, a similar position. You're with the Buffalo.